Welcome back, friends. In this video lecture, we will discuss certain viral STDs. Okay, and we will begin with a very common and more dreadful disease that is called as hepatitis B. Okay, hepatitis B. So hepatitis B is a sexually transmitted disease. Though it is not only sexually transmitted. It is transmitted through other means as well. I will tell you just in a while. But one of its mode of transmission is through sex act. That's why it's included under sexually transmitted diseases. Fine. This hepatitis B is caused by a virus called as HBV. HBV means hepatitis B virus. Hepatitis B virus. Now, this hepatitis B virus, its genetic material is not RNA, but it has DNA as its genetic material. And that DNA too is not single-stranded, that is double-stranded as normal DNA. So, it is said that HBV is a DS. DS means double-stranded DNA virus. So, HBV virus has double-stranded DNA, it is genetic material. And it is said that this hepatitis B is more infectious than HIV. How come? You may wonder. So we have heard that HIV is a very, very perilous and life-taking disease. And you are saying, no, hepatitis B. It's because hepatitis B is more common than HIV. That's why it is said that hepatitis B is more infectious. More infectious means it spreads more fast than HIV, because it spreads not only through the this sex act, but how does a human being acquire this? This is through contaminated food and water. Fine. Like there are many types of hepatitis, hepatitis A, hepatitis A, hepatitis C, then D as well, and hepatitis B. Among all these hepatitis, is this disease is transmitted through sexual intercourse as well. Now, so it is transmitted through sex act. That's why it's called as STD. Fine. But besides being an STD, it can also be transmitted from one person to another person through blood transfusion. So if a person is having HBV or hepatitis B, and if such a person becomes donor of blood, okay, and if this infected blood is transfused into somebody else, another person who will be called as the recipient, this disease will also get transmitted to the recipient. Then third, it can be transmitted through other body fluids. Okay, there are various other fluids through which hepatitis B can get transmitted from one person to another person. Now, let's come to the symptoms. What happens to him? How can we diagnose that such a person is having an abnormality or a disease? Number one, such a person, this person jo hepatitis B infection carry karta hoga, is person ko kya hoga? Nausea and vomiting. Theek hai? He'll be always having nausea, tendency to vomit out things. That's called nausea, and sometimes he may vomit actually. He may, whatever he eats, he may vomit, or even if he does not, he or she does not eat, sit in vomiting of fluid and other contents that may be within the gut. And there's one more thing, that the concentration of bilirubin and biliverdin, these are two pigments. Second, the concentration of, there are two pigments called bilirubin and biliverdin or biliverdin. These are two yellow pigments, and these two pigments are formed when the hemoglobin is broken down in the spleen. Okay, you know, we know the lifespan of RBC is 120 days. When they die, they go to the spleen, they are split, okay, and the hemoglobin is broken down, and during this process, more than two pigments basically, bilirubin, biliverdin, bilfusion, bilcyanin, most particularly these two, bilirubin and biliverdin. These are the waste products. These must be expelled out of the body, and these two pigments, these are removed by the liver. But since hepatitis B, okay, what I should have told you in the beginning, now the hepatitis B is a disease which is basically disease of liver. Hepatitis means inflammation of liver. This is a disease in which liver becomes inflamed, it swells, okay, it becomes hypertrophied because of the this virus. Fine. Now, when the liver is not normal, I told you the function of liver is, liver plays a lot of functions. It's a vital organ. Without liver, a person cannot survive. It plays metabolic rules, okay, removal of toxics from the body, detoxifying the toxic substances, drugs, etc., maintaining overall homeostasis in physiology. Homeostasis in physiology is the function of liver. Now, when the liver becomes, it is infected, when the liver becomes abnormal, what happened? Now, one of the function of liver was to remove the bilirubin and bilirubin, two pigments, your formula, as I told you, by the disintegration of hemoglobin. What happened? When the liver is not normal, their concentration will increase in the body. Now, when bilirubin and bilirubin increases in the body, their concentration increases in the body, you know, whole body becomes pale yellow. The eyes become pale yellow. Whole skin of such a person becomes pale yellow. This is a feature, a symptom by which we can diagnose, we can see that a person is not normal. Such a person will be, pale yellow. His body will be pale yellow because of increased concentration of bilirubin and bilirubin. Because now, when the liver is abnormal, these things are not extracted out of the body, expelled from the body. There can be and other causes as well. Now, this condition, when the bilirubin and bilirubin, the concentration increases in the body and the person feels nausea, person feels vomiting, these conditions are together named or grouped as jaundice. Commonly this disease called as jaundice. Fine. Okay. Now, when the infection continues and continues and the person does not go for treatment, etc., what happens? The liver becomes fibrous, liver becomes hard, it loses its functions, it no more can function now. The part or the whole part of it where the infection is more, what happens? It becomes fibrous, it becomes fatty. And that disease is called as liver cirrhosis. What is liver cirrhosis? Liver cirrhosis is a condition in which the liver becomes fibrous. It becomes hard and becomes non-functional. Right? So such a person, ultimately, if it is not treated, such a person, it dies. And now what we are concerned with is an STD. It gets transmitted through sexual from one person, infected person to another person. So most precautions must be taken into consideration while going for sex act. Now, how can this jaundice, how can this hepatitis B virus be diagnosed with that the person, okay, having such symptoms, whether he is suffering from hepatitis B or something else, how can it be diagnosed? There is a test called as Australian antigen test. Now, we know that this hepatitis B virus, for example, this is a virus, okay, and is having double-stranded DNA, it is genetic material, it has antigens. It is capsid, its protein cover is called as capsid. Now, this capsid has antigens. So, we can look for these antigens within the body of that very person, within the blood of that very person, infected person, we can look for these. And the test through which we identify, we locate, okay, we look for these antigens of this virus, that test is called as Australian antigen test. But nowadays, this test is called as hepatitis B surface antigen test. Hepatitis B surface antigen test. Why this name? Because we know that these antigens are present on the surface of the virus capsid. That's what this test has been called as hepatitis B surface antigen test, or it is written as HBSAG, hepatitis B surface antigen test. What is the treatment for this disease? Okay, the treatment for this disease is vaccination. This disease can be treated through vaccination. That is, what do we do in the vaccination? When we go for vaccination, we either give heat killed organisms or we give dead organisms like that. But in this case, when vaccine is given for hepatitis B virus, what do? We give ready-made antibodies to the person. We give ready-made antibodies to this person or a person who is normal, who does not want to acquire this disease. We give prepared antibodies to such person, and these antibodies make this the person in which the vaccine is given, to which the vaccine is given, they make him immune to this disorder, to this disease. That the person who is given these antibodies will not contract, will not acquire the hepatitis B virus. So, this vaccination or these vaccines or these antibodies, they give rise, they give passive immunity to the human beings. They give passive immunity to who is being vaccinated. Right? Now, what is the schedule of this vaccination? How is this vaccination done? This vaccination is done in three phases. Number is called as 016 security was. Zero means the day, first day on which the vaccination is given is called a zero day, isn't it? First day. Then after a gap of month, one more vaccine is given. Then after a gap of 6 months, one more vaccine is given. Okay, so three vaccines are to be given consecutively, after one on the first day, then after a gap of 1 month, another vaccine, then after a gap of 6 months, another vaccine, and such a person will become immune to the disease for lifelong, and he or she will not need more, you know, vaccination. So vaccination is the only way out right now for hepatitis B. There is no other method of controlling this disease. There's one more point, that this disease may also get transmitted from the pregnant lady to the fetus as well. Now we'll talk about the most common disease nowadays, which everyone knows, and a lot of media is used for making people aware, creating awareness among the masses, among the public, about that disease, and that disease called as AIDS. AIDS is an acronym or abbreviation for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So this disease, AIDS, is not itself a disease, but it is the root cause of many diseases. That's why it's named as syndrome. Okay, it is the root cause of many diseases because of which a person dies. A person who is having full bloom AIDS dies because of many other diseases. AIDS itself does not kill person which is suffering from AIDS. Now, this AIDS, how is this AIDS caused? AIDS is caused by a virus called HIV. HIV stands for Human Immunodeficiency Virus. This HIV is an RNA virus. It is not a DNA virus. It is an RNA virus. And the RNA which is present in this virus is single-stranded. That's why it's called ssRNA. So the genetic material of HIV is single-stranded RNA. We must remember here that there is not only one SSR, there are two single-stranded RNAs. So we'll see from this diagram that there are two, this is one and this is second, two single-stranded RNAs present in this virus. So here we can make a comparison between the hepatitis B virus and the HIV virus. So we see hepatitis B virus is the DNA virus, but HIV is RNA virus. Hepatitis B virus has double-stranded single molecule of DNA, but the HIV has single-stranded two molecules of RNA. Okay, now this virus, this HIV, is called as retrovirus. It's called as retrovirus. Why retrovirus? There's a reason for that. We know that DNA, okay, forms mRNA, or RNA we can say, and then RNA forms proteins. Okay, this is the path of information that flows from DNA up to the formation of proteins. This is called, so DNA, it forms mRNA, and mRNA forms proteins. This is called as central dogma. So what is central dogma? Central dogma is the flow of information from DNA to the mRNA, then mRNA to proteins. And we must always remember that central dogma is universal. That is, there is no other way out through which the information can flow in the cell from DNA onwards or reverse. This only, always in any kind of organism, all the kinds of organisms, information flows from DNA to mRNA and mRNA to proteins. But in case of retroviruses, what happens? We know that in case of retroviruses, for example, HIV. HIV ka genetic material kya hai? RNA. So, ab yahan RNA se protein banega nahi, kyunki information kahan se chalna hai? Abhi humne kaha ki central dogma universal hai. Information DNA se chalna hoga. To yahan par kya hoga? RNA virus mein kya hota hai? RNA se pehle DNA banta hai. First, RNA forms DNA. Okay? Then DNA forms RNA and then proteins. So what is happening here? Since I told you that DNA forms RNA or mRNA, it's called a transcription. Now this is called a transcription. When DNA forms RNA, this is called as transcription. Now if RNA forms DNA, this is reverse of this. Normally hota kya hai? DNA se banta hai RNA, and this is called as transcription. This is called as transcription. Now agar RNA se hi DNA bana, to ye to transcription ka reverse ho gaya. And this is called as reverse transcription. So the RNA forms DNA. In case of these RNA viruses, what happens? RNA first forms DNA and then DNA forms RNA and RNA forms proteins. This formation of DNA from RNA is called as reverse transcription. It's called as reverse transcription. And this is catalyzed. This reaction is performed. This reaction is carried out by a very, very important enzyme called as reverse transcriptase. Reverse transcriptase. Reverse transcriptase is the enzyme present in HIV. That's now see, I told you that HIV is called as retrovirus. Why retrovirus? It means reverse. In these viruses or in this virus, what happens? The RNA first forms DNA. That is the reverse of in the process that actually takes place. That is DNA forms RNA. Here reverse takes place. RNA forms DNA. That's why they call it retroviruses, reverse viruses. Okay, we got it. Now let us see the structure of this HIV. Now HIV, I told you that HIV has two molecules of SSR, two molecules of single stranded RNA. Now this is one molecule. This is okay. I am putting my pen over here. This is one molecule of SSRNA. This second single stranded RNA. Fine. Besides this, what I told you that there is an important enzyme, two of these, and that important enzyme is reverse transcriptase. This is the reverse transcriptase. Okay. I have labeled it here. Reverse transcription. This enzyme is on this molecule and this on this molecule. Then, in addition to reverse transcriptase, there is one more important enzyme called as integrase. Called as integrase. This is the integrase. This is very important. This enzyme. This helps the integration of the viral DNA with the DNA of the host later on. Uske baad ye jo genetic material hai RNA hai. This is covered over by a protein covering. Is covered over by a protein covering, and that protein covering is called as capsid. That protein covering is called as capsid. Capsid ke bahar jo HIV ka virus hota hai, capsid ke bahar bhi ek cover hota hai, glycoprotein cover. Okay, glycoprotein cover. Aur is glycoprotein mein kuch antigens hote hain. Ye antigens jo no black structures hote hain, ye basically host se derive karta hai. Ye antigens jo hai, these antigens are called as GP120. You must remember, these antigens are called as GP120. Aur ये GP120 ये एंटीजन जो है दे रिमेन मास्क्ड ऑल द टाइम, दे रिमेन मास्क्ड. ये छुपा के रखता है एंटीजन. अदरवाइज एंटीजन है तो हम इसको पहचान सकते थे, लेकिन हम इसको पहचान, वी आर नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज दिस वायरस, और आर इम्यून सेल्स आर नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज दिस वायरस, बिकॉज दिस वायरस कीप्स दीज एंटीजन मास्क. दिस वन मोर रीजन वाई आर नॉट वी एबल टू डिवाइस सम ट्रीटमेंट, you know, some best treatment, targeted treatment, okay, some viable treatment against AIDS. The reason is that the enzyme reverse transcriptase has no proofreading activity. It lacks proofreading activity. This proofreading, we will talk about this proofreading activity once we study the second part of the molecular inheritance of our biology. That's basically included in the botany part. Okay, well, once we study that, we'll come to know about this proofreading activity. So here we must remember, we must keep in mind that reverse transcriptase does not have proofreading activity, and because of this, the rate of mutation in HIV virus is more, and that's why every time a new virus is formed is different from the previous one. Okay, a new virus, new HIV is always different from the previous one. So it befools the body cells. Our body cells are not able to recognize it, mark it, notice it. They become befooled and they are helpless, and it keeps them destroying them. We'll talk about it. So these GP20, these basically antigens, they are masked all the time. Now let's talk about something about the history of this AIDS. First case of HIV positive. Individual was, you know, it was noted in 1981 in USA. First case was reported from USA in 1981. In India, first case of AIDS or HIV was reported from Chennai in 1986. And December 1st of, you know, every year, December 1st is celebrated as AIDS Day. You must remember this date, this very important date. December 1st is celebrated as World AIDS Day. On this day, different symposia, workshops are celebrated, okay, carried out to create awareness about the whole disease, whole scenario. And the World AIDS Day
you know, it is indicated by a crossed ribbon called, it is a red colored ribbon and it is in the form of a cross. Okay, it is called
red ribbon, red cross. This is mark, hallmark or hallmark, okay, of the AIDS, this red ribbon. Now, what are the symptoms of AIDS? Okay, when a particular person is suffering from AIDS, what are the symptoms which they say? Number one, there is mild fever. माइल्ड इस इंडिविजुअल को इनिशियली माइल्ड फीवर होता है और यूजुअली ये माइल्ड फीवर जब होता है तो हम कहते हैं मौसम की वजह से है, इस वजह से है, उस वजह से है, हम इसको नेगलेक्ट करते हैं, लेकिन फीवर जब भी है इसको नेगलेक्ट नहीं करना चाहिए, वी मस्ट गो फॉर टेस्टिंग. सो माइल्ड फीवर इज देयर एंड इफ दीज सिम्टम्स आर नॉट टेकन इन केयर ऑफ, इफ वन फॉरगेट्स देम, इग्नोर्स देम, slowly what happens, loss of weight occurs. Weight loss होगा तो कोई कहता नहीं, weight loss होगा तो no problem, कोई होता रहता है फिर हो जाएगा, नहीं, weight loss है तो it may be a problem, ठीक है. Then if it continues, opportunistic infections, cold, influenza, ठीक है ना, कार्टर, जुकाम, ये सारी चीजें होती रहती हैं कंटिन्यूसली एंड दे पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ स्किन कैंसर occurs. वो ऐसा स्किन कैंसर यहाँ होता है जो सिर्फ एड्स की वजह से ही होता है, बाकी किसी कंडीशन से नहीं होता है. पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ स्किन कैंसर ऑकर्स. नाउ ये होता क्यों, ये सारी चीजें बेसिकली जब एड्स होता है, जब एक बंदा एचआईवी पॉजिटिव हो गया तो व्हाट हैपेंस टू हिम, दिस एचआईवी पॉजिटिव व्हाट हैपेंस, ये वायरस जो है, ओके, व्हेन इट कम्स इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द टी हेल्पर सेल्स, टी हेल्पर सेल्स जो है, व्हेन इट कम्स इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द टी हेल्पर सेल के ऊपर एक रिसेप्टर, that's called a CD4 receptor. CD4 receptor के साथ GP120 contact में आ जाता है और जब ये contact आ जाता है उसी वक्त क्या होता है, this RNA is injected into T helper cell. Injects its RNA into T helper cell. जब RNA T helper cell के अंदर चला गया, वहां पर क्या है, RNA DNA बनाएगा, DNA integrate होगा host के साथ, वहां replication होगी, बहुत सारे RNA बनेंगे इस virus के. तो एक आरएनए चला गया था या दो आरएनए चले गए थे बाहर, इस टी हेल्पर सेल के अंदर कितने आरएनए बनते हैं, हजारों आरएनए बनते हैं. जब बहुत सारे आरएनए बन गए, व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस सेल रप्चर्स, ये हेल्पर सेल रप्चर होगी और वो बहुत सारे आरएनए जो वहां से निकले वो वायरस बनाएंगे, वो और सेल्स को इन्फेक्ट करेंगे. इस तरह से सारी की सारी हेल्पर सेल्स जो है डिसइंटीग्रेट होती है. आप कहेंगे सर हेल्पर सेल डिसइंटीग्रेट हो गया क्या, उसे क्या प्रॉब्लम होगी, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर हमारा इम्यून सिस्टम जो है इट्स मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स, ओके, लिम्फोसाइट्स, बी लिम्फोसाइट, टी लिम्फोसाइट, ये जो है ये हमारे इम्यून सिस्टम की सेल्स है, दीज आर द वॉरियर्स ऑफ आवर इम्यून सिस्टम, ये हमारे गार्ड्स है. अब हेल्पर सेल जो अब ये टी सेल्स जो है, टी सेल्स की टाइप्स है, साइटोटॉक्सिक टी सेल्स है, सप्रेसर टी सेल्स है, हेल्पर टी सेल्स है. हेल्पर टी सेल का मतलब ये हेल्प करती है, किसमें हेल्प करती है, ये हेल्पर टी सेल बेसिकली जो भी कोई माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इन्वेडर हमारे बॉडी में चला जाता है, ये हेल्पर सेल उसको रिकॉग्नाइज करती है, रिकॉग्नाइज करने के बाद इंफॉर्मेशन भेजती है बाकी सेल्स को कि कोई इन्वेडर आ गया है, आप जाग जाओ, ओके, इन्वेडर हैज एंटर द बॉडी, यू नो, बी प्रिपेयर्ड. और फिर बी सेल, तो हेल्पर सेल क्या करते हैं, बी सेल को स्टिमुलेट करती है. जब बी सेल स्टिमुलेट हो जाए, व्हेन बी सेल बिकम स्टिमुलेटेड, बी सेल डिवाइड्स, फॉर्म्स प्लाज्मा सेल, एंड प्लाज्मा सेल इट सीक्रेट्स एंटीबॉडीज, एंड ऑल दोस एंटीबॉडीज, देन व्हाट डू द एंटीबॉडीज डू, दे गो एंड कैच द इन्वेडर, कैच द पैथोजन, कैच द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, कैच द ऑनस्लॉट एंड किल the onslaughter or whatever they have to do, they do that, okay, or make the pathogen susceptible for other action, rest for their action. Now when the helper cell hi khatam hogi to baaki cells kya karenge, unko pata bhi nahi chalega, body ko pata hi nahi chalta andar kaun hai. HIV virus ne kya kiya, helper cell ko khatam kiya, body ko pata nahi chala. Jab body ko pata nahi chala, okay, to ab kya hai, koi bhi agent aayega, koi bhi pathogen andar aayega, helper cell hi nahi hai to wo to pehchana nahi jayega. इन्फ्लुएंजा का वायरस आएगा, कोल्ड का वायरस आएगा, कोई और सारे वायरस आएंगे और ये इंसान जो है बीमार हो जाता है, एंड फुल ब्लूम ये इंसान जो है इसकी डेथ हो जाती है. तो अब ठीक है, सिम्टम्स तो है हमारे पास, अब किस तरह से हम ये जो है ना कंफर्म करें कि एक इंडिविजुअल एचआईवी पॉजिटिव है या नहीं है. हाउ टू कंफर्म, डायग्नोसिस क्या है, व्हाट इज द डायग्नोसिस, डायग्नोसिस के लिए एक टेस्ट होता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एलिसा, ELISA. ELISA is a test with the help of which we can determine whether a person is HIV positive or not. ELISA means enzyme, E for enzyme, L for linked, enzyme linked, I for immuno, enzyme linked immuno, S for sorbent, S-O-R-B-E-N-T. Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, A for assay, assay means test. In this, what we do, we determine antibodies which are formed within the body against this HIV. If it is positive, if the result is positive, then we say the person is HIV positive. If the result is negative, then we say the person is HIV negative. Now, okay, diagnosis there, symptoms are there. How can be it treated? Is it curable? Till date, HIV is not curable. There is no such drug which can 100% kill this virus. Though attempts are going on, efforts are on to produce a vaccine, but till date we have not been able to develop a reliable vaccine, we can say. Aisa hamare paas koi reliable vaccine nahi hai jo AIDS se humko bacha sake ya control kar sake. Ha, ek cheez hai ki ye AIDS jo hai, if the mother is pregnant, the AIDS virus can cross the placental barrier and it can cause AIDS to the fetus as well. Lekin अगर हमको अर्ली पता चलता है कि एड्स, इस लेडी को एड्स है, प्रेग्नेंट है, तो हम वी हैव डेवलप्ड द ड्रग्स, हमारे पास ड्रग्स है, एंटीबॉडीज है जो एड्स वायरस को रोक सकती हैं एंड द एड्स वायरस कैन नॉट इन्फेक्ट द न्यू बॉर्न बेबी और द फीटस, वो हमारे पास है. दैट्स वाई एवरी प्रेगनेंट लेडी जो है, जब भी कोई प्रेगनेंट है तो पहला इसको जो टेस्ट कराया जाता है वो एड्स का टेस्ट कराया जाता है. फाइन, नाउ हाँ, ट्रीटमेंट हमारे पास है कुछ हद तक. टू सम एक्सटेंट वी कैन मिनिमाइज the invasion of this virus, we can minimize its actions, we can stop him for some time, and we have a drug called AZT. AZT means azido thymidine. So this is a drug of choice in the market. This is a drug of choice, the drug of choice of doctors. They prescribe this drug and this helps in controlling the AIDS for some time. Then nowadays there's a therapy, there's a method called HART, HAART, HART. HART is a method, okay, HART is a procedure through which the AIDS is regulated or stopped, and HART is highly active antiretroviral therapy, highly active antiretroviral therapy, through which we can control the AIDS, control AIDS invasion. Okay, so we saw two important STD viral diseases. In the next video, we'll be talking about other viral STDs. Thank you very much. So let's continue with these STDs and let's talk about few more STDs. Another STD is genital herpes. Okay, genital herpes. It's also a viral STD. Now the genital herpes is caused by type 2 herpes simplex virus. So genital herpes is caused by a virus and the name of the virus is type 2 herpes simplex virus. What are the symptoms in both males and females? When there is infection of this virus, it causes the development of watery blisters on external genitalia. In both males and females, in case of males on the penis and in case of females around the labia majora, what happens? Watery blisters develop. Okay, and then they rupture. Okay, they develop and they rupture. There is not a particular treatment for this, but it can be controlled. Now the problem is when, if a lady is pregnant and when and the lady is suffering from this disease, at the time of parturition, if the blisters rupture, the fluid is going to touch the baby and that is harmful for the baby. Then if we talk about the treatment, there is no reliable particular treatment, though the disease can be controlled to some extent. Then there is one more problem, one more STD, that is genital warts. The genital warts, this disorder, this disease, STD, this is STD, that is, it spreads through sexual intercourse, and it is caused by human papilloma virus. This genital warts disease is caused by human papilloma virus. In this is what happens, certain hard structures, okay, certain hard structures, globular structures, they appear on the external genitalia, the labia majora, labia minora, perianal area, or on the penis. In case of males, certain hard structures, hard circular structures arise or develop on the external genitalia. And the more important thing about this HPV virus or this genital warts virus, human papilloma virus, is that it is now known that in females, cervical cancer is caused by this virus. So it causes cervical cancer. This is one of the prevalent cancers among females. This is a killer of the females. And now it has been seen that this human papilloma virus, it also causes tumors on genitalia. So the occurrence of tumors on genitalia is also caused by human papilloma virus. Okay, these were the diseases, STDs caused by viruses. There are a few more diseases caused by which are not so much of great importance, because they can be treated instantly, and they are caused by either fungus or by protozoans. The one of the fungal diseases that is caused, that is an STD. So let's now see the fungal disease, that is vaginal candidiasis. It is also an STD. This vaginal candidiasis is caused by a fungus called as Candida albicans. Candida albicans. So this is fungal disease. What this is prevalent both in males as well as females. Now, what are the symptoms? Okay, the most common symptom of this vaginal candidiasis is inflammation of urinogenital tract, inflammation of vagina particularly, and the whole urinogenital tract. And there is the discharge of foul smelling fluid from the vagina. Okay, it's more prevalent in females. So what happens? Of foul smelling discharge comes out of the vagina. This is an indication that there is the fungal infection. One more important symptom is itching. Okay, there is an urge to itch the reproductive part, that is the external genitalia or anal genital tract. Okay, now what, how can be treated? The simple and antifungal drug called as clotrimazole. It is clotrimazole should be used, green or tablets, and it will cure the disease. It's a curable disease. Then what, there's one more STD, and that is trichomoniasis. That is trichomoniasis. Now this trichomoniasis is a protozoan STD. This is caused by a protozoan, and the protozoan is Trichomonas vaginalis. This is both found both in males and females. So the agent is Trichomonas vaginalis. What are the symptoms? Again, inflammation of urinogenital tract, and there is itching. There is urge to itch. So there is one more thing, that is burning sensation. Okay, the person feels burning sensation in the reproductive tract, particularly in the genital tract or in genitalia. And this is a curable disease as well. This can be cured totally by the intake of the drug metronidazole. Okay, metronidazole should be taken, and this will treat the disease. So as such, we completed the sexually transmitted diseases. Thank you very much.